everybody. Welcome. I am going to be working on a map for Merith's Crossing, the small village that is going to be host to a game I have planned for KoboldCon on May 1st. The adventure is going to be named Mayday, 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 and involves a helping out in the village organizer Mayfret, and helping her save the festival. But now for the map of Merith's Crossing, we're going to start with going in with a new drawing, cities, next. Taboo cities. This is Merith's Crossing. And it's 1250 by 1024. Give or take. And finish. That's going to put us in a position to save off our map. With the correct name and the correct location. Next step is to go under draw. Might need to check some settings in my stream. It doesn't look like you're seeing the various options that are popping up. Which would probably be more than a little useful if you're trying to follow along and learn how to do what I'm doing. Interesting. Okay, now I've just learned that for capturing this application, it doesn't capture all of the extra bits and pieces. But that's okay. You'll at least be able to see me creating the map. So I'm now importing a file that I created on the Wataboo site. And converted into a DXF. Now after going to draw, insert file, and selecting the file I want, I need to type the place of 0,0. Which is going to put it in the way bottom corner here, and you can't even see it. Then I go over to the scale button and choose non-visual scale. Come back and collect prior. It's telling me that there's 420 selected. Select entries, 420 picked. Do it. And now I'm going to scale this map up by 400%. and scale center is 0, 0. Now, oddly enough, that didn't seem to pull up quite right. But it is close. So I'm going to move. I'm going to select prior. Do it. And I'm going to take my little town here and move it up into the center of this here map. Actually, I'm going to put it in the corner here. And then refresh. And we've now got a slightly better view. So I'm guessing this map didn't need to be quite this big. I'll resize it in a little bit. So the once the map has been pulled in, that's when things start getting a little bit trickier. Because the first thing I need to do is erase some extras, which I do by erasing according to color. I erase color 42. All of the options that are not hollow. Refresh. That gets rid of a number of lines that I didn't need. I will erase this yellow box because I don't need it. I will also erase by color, which is an option from the right-click menu. Color 245. Do it. And erase by color everything that's colored as 31. Do it. And we'll redraw, and we can more or less make out that there's something left here. Yes, I will go ahead and fix the drawing area since it doesn't need to be this big. We're going to make it 750. Actually, still a bit big, so let's reduce it a little more. I gotta double check my ratios here. Here is gonna fit. Okay, see, I just selected everything on the page. I'm gonna drag over here and unselect the ones that I don't want, and then say do it. I can grab and move my little village. And refresh the screen. That looks a bit better. I am going to trim this off there. And I'm gonna trim it off on this side. I'm gonna back that up. And now I'm gonna trim this. I'm gonna trim it up here. Trim this. Trim it just off the edge. Trim it just past the edge. Do the same with these. For the roads. And you'll see that all of those pieces are now going to disappear behind the frame of that appears once I'm finished. And that's kind of odd that should show up like that, because that should have been removed. Looks like there's two rows on there, but that's all good. Now, the next thing you want to do is to go in and change draw like. And I'm going to select the rivers. And I want this to be a river 10. River 25. So change like draw tool. River 25. I select my river. And change it. I forgot to change my sheet. So we'll back that off. I need to go in and change my sheet first to water and rivers. Apply. Okay. Now I can do my change like draw tool. To river 25. Select my rivers and do it. That's going to drop my rivers onto the right layer, so it'll appear correctly. And now I want to change to roads. And I'm going to do the draw like tool again. I'm going to grab my dirt road. I'm going to grab my two roads that lead out of the village. Select do it. That sets up those two. This next one is a little bit trickier. I have to do my city block. Apply, okay. And again, using the draw like tool, which is found by right clicking on the properties button, which is right here So draw like tool, and I am now going to select. I need my city block default. There we go. And I'm going to select this by color. And the color, of course, is 42, which will select all of my buildings. Which is 66 total, and do it. Yes. Now all of my village buildings have popped up a bit more. Next one, I can do right click, change draw like. I set my sheet to fields and furrows. Train field furrows tool, and I'm going to select by color. The color is 107, and that highlights all of my fields, all the furrows for my fields. And say do it, yes, and you can now see that all of those have been covered over. I do not have any city walls, so I do not need to do those. I should probably switch back to my road. Or no. Okay. So. Okay, I see, and now I can come in here and I can hide the original import, and I'm going to switch to the fields layer. Apply OK. And you can see now that those all the odd colors that were showing up before are no longer there. I'm going to go ahead and clean up these items if I can. Okay, it doesn't seem to want to go in and trim, but that'll be okay. Now I do want to zoom in so I can see my fields. And I'm going to come in. No matching floor. Not sure why that's not working. That's okay. I can click my terrain over here, and we are going to do some brown fields to start. This is going to be one of the ones that's already planted. And I can just draw a shape around my furrows, and we'll draw another one over here. Doesn't have to be too exact here. And for anyone that's driven a tractor, you probably know doing real exact isn't. real easy. It only looks that way from the sky. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, so I need another one of these. I will make this one also a brown field. But I just covered up my rows. Well, actually, I didn't, because once it redraws, they will automatically pop back to the surface. So now that we have that one, we will now put in some green fields. I'm gonna say this one's a nice green field over here. And who doesn't enjoy a good green field? And this one will be a green field. And this last one will also be a green field. Right along the water's edge there. Tempted to actually go back and turn that into a cranberry bog if I could, but we'll see. Before I try to do anything weird like that, I've got another set here. Edges. Oops, that was the wrong one. I wanted this one. Gonna have to redo that. Oh. Let me go in. This is how you fix mistakes. Select the properties tool. Select the item you want to change. Select do it. Now, my fill style that I wanted. See if it's listed. If it's not listed, things get a little bit trickier. There we go, dry grass. I think that's the one. Yeah, that's better. And we'll drop some more crops in here. I will admit that it took me quite a long time to get used to using Campaign Cartographer, but now that I have, I absolutely love it. Because the maps come out beautiful. I mean, this one is currently looking a little sketchy. But one of the reasons for that is I haven't turned on the effects yet. When I turn on the effects, now we've got some fading along the edges. But the riverbanks, the edgings on the houses, just suddenly becomes so much nicer. Now, gee, that doesn't look quite right there, for the terrain underneath. village. I'm thinking it probably needs to look a little bit more trod. How about we do some dark green around the village? Draw that around, do that, and now let's see how that looks. That looks kind of funky because I didn't put it on the right layer. So let me grab my tool. Do it. We're going to move it to background sheet. And let's see if this looks a bit better. I know what I did. I used the wrong tool. Erase. Do it. Just gonna yank that right out of there entirely. Now, let me go back and make sure I got the right tool this time. Grab the wrong one again, damn it. I need this one. A little better. I think I'd like it better if I could see it better. So I'm going to go ahead and try changing fill style on this to dirt brown. There we go. Now we've got some spots of grass and a little park down here by the river's edge. But a lot of dirt in the village, which is going to happen as you're moving stuff around and people are walking and doing all that good stuff. See how this is going there. And we got some pre-made trees and stuff that I've put that I can pull in. Not sure I want to use those. Do want is a vegetation tool. There's a nice forest tool, because of course wouldn't be much of a town if it didn't happen to be near a forest in the middle of nowhere. I mean, really, what kind of D&D town do you think we are? So, start that outside. Run it right along the edge here. Because the village has only cleared away the land they needed. Another chunk of land here. And one more here. This one goes pretty much right up to the road. That looks pretty good for adding trees or general forest, but when do you always see just that? There's always some more trees and whatnot around. I'm gonna put a little copse over here. And then I'm going to switch over a different vegetation tool, which is a tree. And this is going to let me draw in, just add some small random trees dotting the area. Have a couple even over here. There's a couple down by the riverside. And those are kind of small trees, so I am going to clear off. I'm going to repeat it. And this time I'm going to drag out a little bigger. And this is going to let me make some larger trees, some of which I'm going to knock on the edges really close to these small trees. By doing that, we end up with some much nicer looking edges. And yeah, I like to knock a couple in close to clean up some of the edges on the forest itself. Now we'll do a quick redraw, and the effects kick in on the vegetation layer to clean up the edges. Now we've got a much nicer looking map. Thank you. looking at this thing again, I really want to get this trimmed. That didn't work. Okay, select entity to trim to, select entity to trim. Okay, I've gotten a little tired of fighting with stuff, so I'm bringing this one down to do the trim. I'm gonna trim it to there. Now, I'm going to do another to do the trim and trim it. Thank you. go. Now I show all again. And that should have cleaned up that bit of river sticking out the bottom. Now here's a little issue. I've got that there, but I need some bridges. Let's see what I have for bridges. I don't want anything that looks too fancy in here. But, you know, given the rest of it, and these all look kind of fancy for this. So, let's see. Switching off for something that's not quite so fancy. That still looks a little fancy. Nope, I'm not looking for furniture. Looking for structures, bridges. Towers, walkways. Big, line it up. Whoa, need to make it a little bigger. A little bigger, maybe a little smaller. Line it up better this way. There we go. Drop that right there. And line this one up across here. That needs to be a little bigger. Put another bridge there. Actually, I'm going to pull both of those out and reset them because I need to make them a little bigger. Oops. One. And obviously this one has lots of issues because it seems to run into the side of a building. But that's because that building paid for the bridge. At least that's the story I'm telling, and I'm not changing it. So now I can go back in here and turn off the import, which will make those yellow bridge lines go away. At least it should have made the yellow bridge lines go away. It would have if I had selected the right thing. Let's see. There we go. And now we can zoom out a bit. And And switch over here so we can see our map. And I think this is looking pretty good. We've got our fields, our trees, our village, our river. And this is a rather large village when you actually look at it. Kind of proud of them. But let's see. We've got those pieces done. And now it's time to start looking at some other bits and pieces to clean up this map. Don't really need any of those options. Having a scale on the map would be nice. And we will reset that to here. Corner. And it's prompting me for the what the scale will be for this map, and I need to double check. Small scale R. It's 100 meters. So for this, I'm going to leave it at 100 meters. Oh, no, I didn't want to do that. Now that I'm thinking about it, I wanted to convert this to feet. So that's going to be 300 feet. Give or take. We're also going to want to add the map title so we can remember. Oh, it forgot. But this is Merith's crossing. Good old Merith. We're glad he crossed the river here. Okay. That's huge. Not going to do us any good. So I'm going to right click, move scale rotate. Select that. Do that. Do it. Oops. Control Z. Let's change what we're looking at here. Actually, we don't have to. So I'm going to grab this. I'm going to drag it back out here. Merith's crossing. Add this back on. Okay, that looks a little better. Now let's see if I can clear, move in scale, grab that bit, do it. Grab it in the center, drag it up onto the forest, but I'm also gonna enlarge it a little bit. Now let's see how that looks. There we go. This is coming right along. We'll take a nice little compass, drop it over here, because who doesn't need to know where north is? And look at that. We're coming up on 4 o'clock. So in 1 hour, I went from having a internet-generated map, very basic, to having a map that's just about ready. One of the finishing touches I like to put on it is to change the frame, because I like to frame my maps. So I will grab this, do it. I will change the fill style to be wood. Usually I use cherry. Okay. And I grabbed too much. Control Z can be your friend. So let's try this again. Just this one. Just that one. Do it. We're going to change this to cherry. Okay. There we go. Redraw it. Now it's got a nice little edging on it. But I'm not quite done. And actually, I don't particularly like that, the way that came out. Now that I'm looking at it, because that's the planking. I didn't want it planked. Yeah, okay, so I'm being fussy. It's my map, I can be. There we go, that's the one I wanted. That's a bit better. Now, let's see. That's on the map border. So I'm going to come down here to the map border, and I am going to add a bevel. Five units. Map units. Apply. Looks like I might need to go to 10. Oh, this is the one I wanted. That's why. This is kind of interesting, because while I'm trying to do this, there we go. And you see we've got a bit of a bevel on there. Now we've got a nice edging on the map. I can see that I put my compass in the wrong spot. So I will move it over a little bit. Redraw. There we go. So now we have a map of Merith's Crossing. Thank you for whoever's watching it. I hope you enjoy it and get some ideas. Also, please take the time to check out my extra life and possibly donate to help the kids. Thank you.